Hi, in this video, I will be talking about how to construct confidence intervals. We'll start by defining a point estimate. A point estimate is a single value used to estimate a population parameter. And then a confidence interval, this is a formula that tells us how to use sample data to calculate an interval that estimates a population parameter. So we start by constructing a confidence interval for the population mean when the population standard deviation is known. In this case, if the population standard deviation sigma is unknown and our sample size n is large, that is n is greater than or equal to 30, we can use s, the sample standard deviation, in place of sigma. Now we'll look at the example. A manager at a shopping mall wants to estimate the average mean amount spent by customers per visit. A sample of 55 customers were surveyed. The mean amount of $90.50 with a standard deviation of $22.10 were obtained. Construct a 95% confidence interval for the population mean. In this question, we are going to be using the formula x bar plus or minus e, where my e is my margin of error. I'm going to compute e by taking the critical value, z alpha over 2, multiplied by sigma. In this case, my sigma will be replaced by s because the sample standard deviation is what is given. And then my sample size in this case with is 55. So my critical value is based on the confidence interval of 95%. My 1 minus alpha is 0.95, hence my alpha will be 0.05. So my alpha over 2 will be 0.025. So I will go to Excel, and in any cell I will type num.s.inv 0.025, and it returns for me the critical value 1.96. Now I'm going to have this on both the right tail and the left tail. So thus I have plus or minus 1.96. Now I can compute my margin of error by taking my critical value 1.96 multiplied by my sigma, which I'm replacing by s in this case, which is 22.10. And then in the denominator, I'll take the square root of n, which is square root of 55. When I compute this to two decimal places, I would get 5.84. So I will be adding this to the sample mean and to get the upper limit, and then subtracting from the sample mean to get the lower limit. So as a result of that, my lower limit will be 84.66, less than mil, less than 96.34. I can thus conclude that we are 95% confident that the average amount spent per visit by all customers at the shopping mall is between $84.66 and $96.34. Next, we construct a confidence interval for the population mean when sigma is unknown and n is small, where n is less than 30. We note that when n is sufficiently large, that is, n is greater than or equal to 30, the t distribution will approximate to a z distribution. Now we look at the next example. A student wants to estimate the average amount spent on meals by students monthly. She sampled 12 students and she recorded how much each spends on meals per month. We want to construct a 90% confidence interval for the population mean. Now, this will be the data containing the amount spent by the 12 students. So we're going to start by going to Excel to get the summary statistics. Excel can also give us the margin of error. Once we are in Excel, we're going to go to data analysis, and then we'll click on descriptive statistics and then OK. Then I will highlight the data, put that in, and then check the box summary statistics and then the confidence level for means. In this case, my confidence level is 90%, so I'll change that to 90, and then I'll click OK. Now, once the output shows up here, again, the key results I need, if I look at the first cell, I have my mean, and the last cell, I have my margin of error. So I can straight away add and subtract to get the upper limit and the lower limit. So if I look at the table and then I look at the summary statistics I have in there, now I can use the formula again, X bar plus E, where my E is T alpha over 2 multiplied by S over square root of N. And the degrees of freedom using the T distribution here will be N minus 1. So in this case, I'm 90% confidence interval. So my 1 minus alpha is 0.9 and my alpha will be 0.1. So as a result of that, my alpha over 2 will be 0.05 and the degrees of freedom will be 12 minus 1. So that will be 11. So when I type this formula into any cell in Excel, it returns for me 1.796. Again, for the confidence interval, I have a value on the left tail and another one on the right tail, hence I have plus minus. Next, I'm going to use the summary statistics from the table. My critical value to compute the margin of error, 1.796. From the table right there, I can get the sample standard deviation, which is 45.34, and my N, which is the counts there, which is 12. So in the denominator, I have the square root of 12. So when I compute my E, I get 23.51. Again, if you look at the output from Excel, you will see it in that last cell. It is exactly the same value. So all I need to do to get the upper confidence limit, I will take my mean, which is at the top there, 486.67, plus the margin of error, 23.51. It gives me 510.17. So that will be the upper confidence limit. And then the lower limit will be 486.67 minus the margin of error, 23.51, which gives me 463.16. Hence, I can say that we are 90% confident that the average amount spent on meals monthly by students is between $463.16 and $510.17. Next, we construct the confidence interval for P, the population proportion. The sample size must be large. That means my NP hat must be greater than or equal to 15. Also, my NQ hat must be greater than or equal to 15. Now, we look at this example. A doctor at a Toronto hospital is interested in estimating the proportion of girls in all births. A random sample of 500 births in Toronto hospitals included 270 girls. Construct a 99% confidence interval estimate of the proportion of girls in all births. Now, to be able to do this, we use the following formula, P hat plus or minus E. Again, my E, which is the margin of error, is obtained by taking the critical value from the standard normal table multiplied by the square root of P hat times Q hat divided by N. In this case, my confidence interval is at 99%. So my alpha will be 1 minus 0.99, which will be 0.01. So when I divide that by 2, I get 0.005. So when I go into any cell in Excel and type in num.s.inv, and then I put in 0.005, it returns for me the critical value on both tails, which will be 2.58. Now I compute my margin of error. First of all, I need to get my P hat, which is the sample proportion. From the question, we have 270 out of 500. This will be 0.54. So I will use that, and my Q hat will be 1 minus 0.54, which will be 0.46. My Z alpha over 2 is 2.58, then my N is 500. So when I put all of that together into the formula, I'll get 0.0575. Again, I will add the margin of error to the sample proportion, which is 0.54. to get the upper limit, which in this case is 0.60. And then I'll subtract the margin of error from the sample proportion, which in this case will give me 0.48, both to two decimal places. We can thus conclude that we are 99% confident that the true population proportion of girls in all births will be between 0.48 and 0.60. Thank you for watching this video.